Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome back to Final Fantasy VIII. The last time we finished up in space, yes you heard me correctly, by saving Rinoa, but not before she let out Sorceress Adele, so all hell is gonna break loose. Then, after saving her by dressing up as a spaceman and literally catching her in the middle of, you know, space itself, we ran across this thing behind us, the Ragnarok ship, which turned out to have been overrun by aliens about 17 years ago. We killed off the aliens because we got damn badasses, and then we landed. But Rinoa got taken away to the Sorceress Memorial because she's a danger, because she is possessed by Sorceress Artemisia, who wants to control or use Adele to time travel, and I don't know. There's all kinds of weird future and past and sorceresses going on. It's bad news bears, man. So anyway, the point is, she's gone to the Sorceress Memorial. That's our bottom bitch. So we're gonna go get her back. And here's the thing, I can't figure out how the hell to get on this bloody ship. Now, yeah, you can walk on it and board the thing, but I'm pretty sure you're just supposed to be able to press a button and get in it like any other vehicle. And I tried going to the lift here to just, you know, go to the cockpit. I cannot for the bloody life of me figure out how to actually, like, the lift won't work, man. Look, it won't work. What do I do? Let's try going over here. There must be somewhere on the ship we can go, right? We have maybe a cutscene. It's hard to tell. Okay, I'm not controlling him. This is good news. This is very good news. It's okay, buddy. Oh, Iron! Hey, I'm back! No shit, thank you for that. How did you get here? I was just fiddling around inside the escape pod. Then the impact from the landing knocked me out for a while. When I came to, it was just me and Pietz. Or Pierre? I'm now wondering, is that Pierre? Is that how you spell Pierre? It's not, right? Piet? We're gonna call him Dave. Oh, the guy who escaped with us. What happened to Alone? No sign of Sis. I hope she's safe. Then after some time, the rescue crew from Istar arrived. They told me about the ship and about you and Rinoa. They gave me a ride over here. I see. Score, you suck. When you jumped out into space, you got me thinking. I was thinking, this guy's bloody insane. I wonder whether I could do something like that. You were like a hero, a very stupid hero. Hey, so where's the heroine? If you think about it in terms of the drug, that's hilarious. Hey man, where's the heroine? I want to get high. Rinoa is just in town to interrupt Zella, as usual. Sup, Squall? So glad you're safe! I hate to tell you this now, but we've got major problems down here. Well, here it goes. Some big thing called Lunatic Pandora came out of nowhere. Matron couldn't achieve what she set out to do because of it, which is okay. Matron's not a sorceress anymore. Matron gave away her power to someone without realizing it.
Yeah.
Rinoa.
To Rinoa. And, oh yeah, the Galbadian military is controlling Lunatic Pandora. They excavated it from the ocean where Estar sank it years ago. Inside the Lunatic Pandora, there's this thing called a crystal pillar. It calls monsters from the moon. The monsters come falling down from the moon. Total panic down here. It wasn't just monsters that came falling down. Sorceress Adele came down along with the machine that confined her. I guess the stream of falling monsters engulfed the machine. Lunatic Pandora caught Adele from that stream. Dr. Odin thinks that may have been Galbadia's true intent. Meaning? Zell, that's enough for now. But Skull! I know we've got problems. But I can't think right now. I'm missing my bottom bitch. What's the matter? Rinoa is a sorceress now. She retrieved Matron's powers. An escort from Istar came to pick Rinoa up. Rinoa is in Istar now. We have to go get her. Was she taken by force? No. It was Rinoa's decision. She was scared about being a sorceress. Scared of being feared, hated. Scared that no one would want to be around her. She said she couldn't handle that. Didn't you try to stop her, Squall? It was Rinoa's decision. Well, why do I have to object? Oh, stop that. What are you talking about? Willis, Why did you go all the way out into space to save Rinoa? To hand her over to Esther? So that you might never see her again? No, right? Wasn't it because you wanted to be with Rinoa? You're a fool! Seriously, broski. A fool, huh? Maybe. What am I doing? I may never get to hear Rinoa's voice ever again. What the hell am I doing? What can I do? Of course. Have you decided? Heading to Estar, right? Pandora, whatever, and Sorceress Adele are out of my hands. I don't even know where to look for Sis. The only thing I know is Rinoa. The only thing I want to do for sure right now is for Rinoa. We're going to get Rinoa back. So we go to the cockpit, I guess. Hey, buddy, you want to play cards? Aw. Doesn't even want to talk. Whoa! Ah! Hey! Excuse me, we're flying. See, you can't see, but I'm pretty sure, if I remember correctly, I think Selfie's the pilot? I hope this ain't the case, but I can picture Selfie in the pilot seat and Selfie screaming, "Woohoo, we're flying!" And standing next to her, a very excited Irvine. I'm pretty sure that's actually correct. See, it's weird that I remember little things like that, just the fact that Selfie is the pilot. Now, you may think that's a major thing, but I don't think it really is. Woo, we're flying! Listen to the goddamn music. It's so happy. Selfie's just amazing! This could be like a... like an 80s TV, like an 80s family TV show. You can just imagine it, can't you? With like all the characters turn around and smiling at the camera and nodding. Like, yeah, we're in a TV show in the 80s. You sure you can fly this? It just kind of took off. I don't know, it's pretty easy. I think I'll be fine. See, if anyone said that to me, again, where's the fucking spaceship? I'd be like, no, get out of the cockpit right now. Let me do it, because clearly you just said you don't know what you're doing. We're all going to crash and die. But there's no guarantee it won't crash. Exactly. No one can predict the future, right? Selfie head for Esther. She's probably at the Sorcerer's Memorial. We're gonna go rescue Rinoa. Oh my god. I'm pretty sure it's exactly the same as everything else. That's an excellent start. I just accidentally landed. Alright. Whee! Didn't it say you can go up and down? That's not how you do it. Goddamn it. You know where we got? Yeah, I know where we're going. So let's go. What does triangle do? Triangle goes back. Oh, so you go forward and back. How does one rotate the camera? Oh, no, you can't go up and down. How did I do that? I don't know. What? How did I get... How is this happening? Oh, it's just up and down on the left stick. All right, I got it. Apparently, you can auto fly from what I remember. So if you click on this... Yes, you can't see.
I have no hands right now.
Well, I do have hands, but not on the thing. You understand. That was quick. Alright, we still need to park. So, forward, and then, alright, easy. Now, there's going to be some story here, obviously, but we're at the point in the game where, essentially, we could go and finish it up right now. As soon as we're done here, I'm pretty sure we can head straight to the final area of the game, get through that, final boss, boom, done. I did promise I'm going to do all the side stuff. Now, this is going to take a few episodes. Probably not half as many as you might imagine, though there is a lot of side stuff to do, but it will be condensed down via editing and whatnot. Plus, I know for the most part what I'm doing. How do I bloody land? I can never remember how bloody land! I thought it was just cross, man! I swear that's what I pressed. God, I suck. Well, so you notice, like, the sun is setting? It's kind of all red now. Don't know why, but it's probably the whole moon, you know, tear-crying monster thing. The lunatic cry, or I forget what it's bloody called already. But you get the point. That might be why. Oh, really? You could give me a battle right there. I probably don't even have any freaking GFs. I'll probably die. Oh, those are imps. I think that's the first time we've ever seen them. You have no GF? You do, though. Alright. Well, since the first time we've seen them, we'll kill them. We will do it with a sped up battle, though. And honestly, Berserk might be the best thing in this situation, because, I mean, it's just gonna make her hit harder, and all she can do is hit anyway, so, fuck it. However, they are hitting quite hard, and they do seem to have a lot of HP. So that sucks. Yeah, whip it. Whip it real good. We might have to run away. I'm not going to mess around with the GS right now anyway, because No, I think we might have to do some fighting at the Sorceress Memorial. I don't actually remember. Can we at least kill one of them? Like, please? Well, she killed herself. But that was probably for the best, you know? She was a loose cannon. Okay, seriously, dude. I've done like 5 that work. I might be exaggerating, but I've done a lot of damage to you. You know what? We're running. This is just infuriating at this point. All right. Should probably revive Quistis, I guess. I don't remember who has, like, what GFs or anything. Okay, first things first. Let's kill that. Should probably revive you as well. Right, so, let's have a quick look. Junction. It's a school. I guess Rinoa had the rest of them. Yeah, that's unfortunate. Alright, switch. You can have Rinoa's, I suppose? No. Junction exchange. There you go. Yes. So, we have to take, like, 4 off of him, because I think he's got, like, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6. So we'll take 3 off of you. Bollocks. You know what? We're going to take them all off for a second here. Except Ifrit, which I think I've already done. No. Oh, that's annoying. Yeah, why have you got Ifrit? Zell was always the guy with Ifrit from... Oh my god, this is so confusing. I don't remember anymore. Okay. Let's just start again here. Just unequip everybody, and we'll go through these, like, one at a freaking time to make sure people get what they need. So, yes. That looks good, too. So we need, like, speed evasion, hit, luck, any of that. Alright, hit, sure, we'll go with that. And either of these will give you speed. Sure, Pandemona. Auto to attack, magic, GF draw, count of half, spirit may as well. Okay, now, Zell. We always give you Ifrit. There you go. Magic. Guess that will give me... Yes. Looking good. Speed and hits. And then we'll give you Leviathan. Yes. To attack. Magic GF draw. 40% strength bonus and order potion. Good. So here's the question. Does Quistis even have any magic? Let me have a look. Magic Quistis. She does. Okay, good. Alright, so Junction, Quistis. She's really level 12. This is insane. When you think that we're almost at the end of the game, she's level 12. 12. Now, yeah, we don't really use her. Our best guy's 29. The max level in this game is 100. But again, enemies level up with you, so there's really no point grinding whatsoever, which kind of... I like that. You know, it's one of the few things... Some people hate it. Because they're like, well, what's the point leveling up then? True, but that means you don't have to grind. So, I don't know, I've kind of... This game gets away with having it work like that because you get stronger in different ways via the GFs and junction magic because of the GFs, etc, etc. Whereas in a game like Oblivion, where enemies do level up with you, they just level up with you. That's all there is to it. You get stronger, they get stronger. The only real way of outdoing them in that game is the equipment, like getting a glass sword instead of like a steel one or something. Anyway, I'm rambling. So, Quistis, you can take the rest of these, and hopefully this is good for you. She definitely needs... Okay, that's most of what we needed. It'd be nice if she had Vitality Junction, but... C'est la vie, such is life, right? There you go. HP, luck, and move fine, I guess. Sure. Why not? Sure. Alright. I'm gonna leave them on low HP, just because limit breaks, basically. Let's make a quick save, shall we? Boop! And then in we go! I still have the speed up on, don't I? By the way, love this music. So good. Don't know if this is the first time we've heard it, though. I don't remember. It might be. Now I've got the Spice Girl song in my head, goddammit. Stop right now, thank you very much. You want to see your comrades off, or comrade off. Comrade? Comrade. I'll make an exception, go ahead. More for you, suckers! We're here to bust her out! It's a bunch of Sifa clones. That's what he's been doing. He's been cloning himself. What are you doing here? I love the way that this is literally the same character. Like, the exact same model. Video games. They were funny when they were old. What are you doing here? This is a restricted area. to do what I should have done earlier. I'll never know unless I do it. What are you talking about? I know what I want and what I have to do. And then suddenly Potty Boy's music hits, like, and Squall's just got like a tear-off suit, and he's just in a thong. And that's what he meant. There's still a chance. I'm not gonna look back. I'm taking Rinoa with me, you punk-ass bitch. What? You must be joking. It's too late. She's got a whip, man. Just stand back. Go, Squall. Here I come to get confused. I guess we're going this way. Hey, baby. I have a gunblade. Rinoa, hold on. I'll get you out in a sec. No, Squall, the gunblade. What am I supposed to do? Come on! Squall, the gunblade. There you go. You know, she was in a little chamber thing, just like Adele. That was her name, right? Sorceress Adele? I'm now wondering if I'm confusing her with the singer. I don't think so. There's a parody in there somewhere, like rolling in the deep space. Squall, don't! I'm a sorceress. I don't give a crap. Rinoa, Squall! Let's go. Piggyback time? Nope. I assume he's supposed to have said something, or maybe he did just wave his hand. Also, you notice? He's bloody huge. Oh, wait a minute, I know who that is because he's huge, that man. So I don't know if they're gonna tell us. I'm pretty sure that's Ward. He's the right size. I've seen him before. That might be the only clue you get about that. I can't remember. Oh, it would make sense as well, because Ward doesn't speak. But you know, he had his throat cut or whatever, which is gross. What's wrong, Rinoa? I'm just a little embarrassed. Why? I was so set on staying in Estar. But then, when you guys rescued me, it made me so happy, and no need to be embarrassed. Yeah, happy is good. Thanks, everybody. Squall. You're awfully quiet. What's up? I have a lot on my mind. He's always quiet, man. As an expert Squall observer, he's thinking about what we do now. Blah, blah, blah. If you think and worry too much, everything tends to turn bad. Squall, why don't we just picture a brighter future?
Whatever.
But seriously, what do we do from here? I'm not really sure, but don't we have to do something about that lunatic Pandora in Estar? After all, the Galbanians are controlling it. Which means Sifra is behind all this too, right? Sifra is Artemisia's puppet. Yeah, and that also Artemisia! We can't let that sorceress from the future mess up our world. Let's go kick her ass!
And chew bubblegum! And we're all out of gum.
With seeds. We're here to destroy the sorceress, right? Zell! Sorry. So, Squall, where are we going? Can we go to the orphanage you guys were talking about in Trabia? The place is in shambles. There's nothing to see there. I want to stay away from places where there are lots of people. I'm a sorceress. If Artemisia, oh my god, I can't read. If Artemisia possesses me again, let's go head to Edia's house. So I believe this is the last sort of story part that we get before it's basically like, hey, you can go to, just end the game now, or do you want to do side shit? You may remember sort of around here, there was an island where a big catcher was popping up. That's a GF we can get. And there's, I think over here, or one of these corners that you can't see. There's like an underwater facility or something like that. And there's two GS there technically, and one, actually two very hard boss fights. So there's a bunch of things like that that we can do. still need to make Doom Train, blah, blah, blah. Point is, we're going to get all the GFs, all the cards, then we're going to end the game. I'm going to consider that 100% done, but, you know, we'll see. So, the house was somewhere down a shore. There you go. Let's autofly there. That's super speed. I'm just rocking out right now as this goddamn music. Oh, we're there already. This is this music you get in the Ragnarok as well. It's kind of amazing. I'm just saying. All right, let's park up this puppy. Just realized as well, because this is an old game, it sort of runs at like 30 or 50 FPS or something strange like that. I think it might even be like 25 FPS. When you do it like this, that's fucking 60 right there. Maybe that's what it does, just doubles the frame rates. And that in turn, because it's probably one of those games that's so old, the frame rate is locked to how quick it goes, blah, blah, blah. I don't know. Let's beat up this jelly eye. 24 damage. You are quite weak, my friend. Quite weak. Let's save again, just so if something terrible happens, we don't have to go through all of that story again. That would be smart. And sometimes I do the smart thing. Not often, though. Bing, bing. Oh, look, it's Angelo, I guess. You, Angelo, aka Dave. Where you going, Dave? Oh. Sorry. About what? I'm sure you want to be alone with her. To school. I never thought you were the rumor. You know. I'll go get Rinoa school. You stay right there. So I'm thinking we're going to get some kind of cheesy, you know, romantic part. But just, you know, suck it up, buttercup. It'll be fine. So, what should I talk about when Rinoa gets here? Nothing about the sorceress, huh? I'm sure she's trying not to think about it. Who cares if she's a sorceress, right? You don't care either, do you, Dave? Rinoa's just Rinoa. I bet it bucks. It didn't buck. You son of a bitch. What'll become of me? Don't worry about it. There have been many good sorceresses. Edea was one. Well, yeah. I mean, she was only a complete fucking tyrant for 2/3 of the game. Yeah. You could be like her. But Edea still... I can't guarantee anything either. If Ultimedia... I can't say Ultimacia. If Ultimacia possesses me again... I trip over that word every time. You saw me. She controlled me in outer space and made me break Adele's seal. What might happen next time? What will I end up doing? Will I end up finding everyone? Scary thought, isn't it? And then wham! She kicks him in the nuts. I was all to me the entire time. Rinoa, even if you end up as the world's enemy, I'll be your knights. It's pretty fucked up when you think about it, he says that. Let's just take a moment to analyze that. What he's essentially saying is, even if you do fall to darkness and become literally Hitler, I will fight with you. Now, I understand that it wouldn't be her fault, right? So he's still protecting the person he loves who is innocent and just being possessed. I get that, but it's pretty fucked up when you think about it. Like, would he really go to those lengths? Would he kill many innocents to protect her? Probably at school. He's kind of insane. If I fall under Ultimacia's control again, Seed will come kill me, right? And the leader of Seed is you, Squall. Skull's sword will pierce my heart. It gets pretty dark here. I guess it's okay if it's you, Skull. Nobody else. I'm not kidding. I actually teared up at this part when I was a kid. I was like, damn, that's fucked up. You know, you're not prepared for that when you're a child. Skull, if that ever happens, that's enough. God damn it. I'll never do anything like that. The sorceress I'm after is not you, Rinoa. My enemy is the sorceress from the future. Oh, the goddamn Mesia. Oh, the goddamn Mesia lives in the future and possesses me. She uses my body as her extension in this world. How will you save me? I'll come up with something. There's gonna be a way. Don't worry. Trust me. I trust you. Well, until you find a way, maybe I should stay in Esther at that memorial. Wouldn't that be better? No. That'd be pointless. I'll just end up going after you again. Rinoa, just stay close to me. No. Those words! What? That's what started everything. What are you talking about? You don't remember? Something I said? Oh, just forget it. No, it's because of the GF. That's why I forgot. That's just an excuse. I mean, she took the words right out of my mouth. Feeling better? Yeah. Can I tell you a story? I had a dream. It was a scary dream. We make a promise. We promise to see shooting stars together. I get dressed up and put on your ring. But the thing is, I can't remember where I'm supposed to meet you. I start to panic. I really want to see you, school. But I don't know where to go. I start running through the mountains, the deserts, the plains, through Timber, Balam, and Galbadia. Damn, she got some stamina. I mean, you don't want to lose a girl like that. When I realize I can't run any longer, I just want to see you so badly. So I scream, school, where are you? Then I woke up, I was crying. I'm sorry, you don't have to say anything. I just felt like I had to tell you. It was just a dream, it doesn't mean anything. Wow. Tell that to Martin Luther King, sir. Don't worry about it. I guess you're right. How about this? I'll be here.
Remember the beginning of the game?
Why? The reason why you couldn't find me was because we haven't promised yet. Promised? I'll be waiting for you. If you come here, you'll find me. I promise. Because for those of you that don't remember, and I suspect most of you won't, but I don't blame you, at the very beginning of the game, during the opening cutscene, these words are on the screen. So there you go. I'll be here too. It's a promise. Thanks, school. Next time, we'll meet for sure. Whoa! Sorry to interrupt, but it's an emergency. We got radio contact from Estar's presidential palace. That's a lot of peace. They have a plan to defeat Artemisia. They want to hire C to execute it. Might be a trap to get Rinoa back in Estar. Oh, and the guy who spoke to... Or we spoke to, his name's Kiros. Could he be... that Kiros? Kiros is in Estar's presidential palace? He wants to hire us? Alright, let's go. It's covering time! Oh, we got the A-team back.
You know what that means, Questus. I'm sorry.
Wait. Switch. Turn it over and hit it, ooh la la la. Hey. Switch. Hello. Skull. You're always looking for a loan with tears in your eyes. Thank you for telling me that. That's creepy as shit. I mean, I know you're a sorceress. You're even dressed like one now, but what was up with it?
Wanna play cards?
She doesn't even want to play cards? Well, tough luck. I'll get you a goddamn card. Squall! Tears in your eyes, Squall! There is something I must tell you. It is about me. I'm a lesbian, but that's okay. I mean, for a start, that's hot. And it's very acceptable these days. Yes, I believe it was 13 years ago. This is when my story begins. I first became a sorceress when I was a child, and once again 13 years ago. That day right here, I encountered a sorceress on the verge of death. I received her powers of my own will. Pay attention. Children. This is where if I had a ruler, I would like smack it on the desk. That sorceress was an entity of fear for my children. I could not let her get to them. But this turned out to be the beginning of my painful story. At this very minute, my bitter story has ended. I now understand there is an end, no matter how painful it may be. Therefore, Squall, you must fight to the end, even though it may bring tragedy to others. Thanks. Tears in the eyes? Now go, Squall. Walk out that door. Don't turn around now, because you ain't welcome here anymore. Can I get in? Can I get in you? There you go. We still haven't done anything with those goddamn chocobo shrine thingies, have we? So you can ride the chocobo, but you have to, like, catch it, and you can pay Choco Billy to get you one, and we have a spaceship now. We don't bloody need that. Where are we going? Estar, Presidential Palace? We should be able to get there easy enough, I would think. Lunatic Pandora. Yeah, it's got an air station. Check this shit out. Super speed! Wait, what? Hang on a minute. This ain't no goddamn air station. Do I just land on this? Do I land on this? That kind of looks like it. Did that work? What the hell? I think I pressed the wrong button. Probably just have to press the get out button. There you go. Look at it! That's so cool, don't you think? If you don't think that's cool, I don't know what's wrong with you. I mean, think about it. This game is from 1999. Or was it 2001? It's from somewhere around there. I think 1999. That is 17 years. I know, I'm a great mathematician. As of this moment. There might be people watching this in like a year or two or five or ten time. Games these days, in 2016, man. How often can you fly a spaceship around and land a motherfucking thing and it's there and like, it's glory, look how big and awesome. Okay, I love it. Anyway, speed up and let's get to, hey bud, you don't look so good. There's too many of them. I think there might be monsters here now from what I remember. Oh yeah, it would make sense because this is where they came down.
Alrighty then, do you want to play cards?
No. Okay. Yeah. Yes. Quite so. I get the feeling we probably can't use the elevators anymore. There is a save point. There was a man in a pipe as well, which would suggest we know we can't. Son of a bitch. Alright then. I love how quick this game saves, by the way. And this is how quick it always used to save. It always used to save at that speed. It was amazing. It blew my mind. I was like, PlayStation 1, you can save that quick? Millions of monsters falling from the sky. Oh, don't exaggerate, man. If there were millions, this place would be covered. Covered. Wouldn't be able to move. I don't remember how to get to the presidential palace. Is it down here? Oh, this might be it, actually. We can't handle it. Yes, you can. Get up. It's endless. What is this? Quake. Not only is it a good video game, it's also a pretty good spell. I should really show you some of these spells at some point. We've gone through the game and barely used any magic at all. Like, I don't... Well, you've seen some that the enemies have used, but I haven't really done so. Somehow they've sealed it to keep the monsters out, but... Do you want to go... probably no, this is the lab, isn't it? We're supposed to be going to the presidential palace. Shit. Can we go in here? No. We'll go up here anyway, just to have a look, since we're here anyhow. I remember this lift being very slow. Yes, this is at super speed. If ever you're wondering, just look in the bottom right, it says high speed down there. That must be a really good draw point. I don't think it was Oldemar. I think it might be like Holy or something. Odin's not here. Odin, whatever. The doctor is at the presidential palace. Son of a biscuit. Alright, let's keep going then. I might cut out the trip, it depends, or maybe I'll just talk to myself incessantly along the way and therefore not have to cut it out. I don't know. The less editing I have to do, the better, because again, when we get to the side stuff, oh man. Put it this way, there's some very, very tough bosses, which are almost certainly going to require me to die several times to get them killed, because... Besides... How do I describe it? Again, essentially, grinding doesn't really help you in this game, like leveling up your character per se. But in grinding, you can level up your GFs, and that does help you. And also learning GF abilities is... That and basically drawing, like, a bunch of magic are the two major ways of making your character stronger. But those are still types of grinding. I may have to do that, I guess is what I'm trying to say. I may have to go and draw, like, 100 fucking Ultimer or whatever I can get my hands on. My grubby little hands. To, make our character stronger, and I might have to grind out a bunch of GFs to level them up, to learn abilities. Either way, I need the Med Data ability, or whatever it's called on Alexander. Speaking of which, how close is he to learning Med whatever it is? Oh, Med... it's not Med Data, it's Med something else. Again, essentially it's the one that levels up potions and shit, so I can make, like, Remedy Pluses. I think it's the only way to get Remedy Pluses. I could be wrong, but I think I'm right. Where's the lifter? When is it coming? I don't think the lifts work anymore, darling. I don't remember how to get to the presidential palace. Well, this is the shopping mall. Tornado. I don't think these all used to be here. I think there are new draw points. I'm actually gonna check the shop. I'm not even sure if we can use them now. I hope so. Because there might be new things here that we want. Let's try checking the bookstore. We're having a sale. Holy crap. Any of these that we don't have? I'm sure there are more than two occult fans. Maybe I'm wrong. Oh, looks like we got all of them. Alright, well, we're just going to assume we have the rest then. So I'm going to try going around the edge here and see if that gets us to... Is that chicken like a bikini down there? Or is that like a little kid or something? I don't know. What the hell are you? Well, I'm scared. It's a kid. It's okay. I'll make it go away. Really? Yeah, so stop crying, you little bitch, and go hide. Okay. And then he doesn't... Oh, my God. Then he doesn't hide. Yes, I know I still have the speed up on, but I don't think right now it's exactly ruining the mood. That right there, that's an iron giant. Now, I know what you're thinking. Why is that important, Jason? Well, it's not really important, but it's kind of cool, because iron giants have been in Final Fantasy, I think since like Final Fantasy 2 or something. And I think in like 12, whichever the one was before 13, the non-MMO one. I think 11 was the MMO, but anyway, whichever one that was, they looked really strange in that. They had like floating limbs and they were weird looking. But in pretty much every other Final Fantasy, they're always sort of like a blue, tanky, armored looking dude with a big machete. Or scimitar, whatever that is. I don't know, it's a very iconic Final Fantasy enemy, so that's why it's very cool to me that we're finally running into one, because it's like an endgame enemy usually as well. It's like a tough thing. I mean, it's probably not that bad, honestly, but it's still, you get what I'm saying. Oh, finally, it's bloody dead, Jesus. Alright. It's actually not hitting very hard at all. I should check to see what it has, because it might have some good shit. Now that we put it to sleep, that's good timing. Haste, you know what? Oh, we kind of want 100 haste and dispel. All right, I'm going to do it. Fuck it. Fuck it. I'm going to cut it out. Oh, shit. I didn't mean to pack it. God damn it, Jason. She attacked us. What? How did that happen? All right, you know what? Let's wake her up. There you go. Only 72 damage. All right. So, like a... No, stop attacking. Oh, my God. Squall. Bastards. Anyway, like I say, I'm going to draw 100 haste on everybody and 100 reflect. We already have shell. Because those two are good spells, they're going to be worth it. Again, since we have so many tough bosses left to take out, it's just a good idea I do this. So, I'll be right back, and I'll bring you in after we're done. Okay, I'm not going to lie to you, that was boring as shit, but finally it worked. I had to use a few lefts and Kurigas to actually keep our team afloat, but I think it was a worthy trade-off. Again, we have 100 Reflects and 100 Haste on everyone. Now, Haste is going to be really good if you junction into your speed, because usually they make sense. Reflect is just a good magic in general for most things. I think probably stuff like Spirit, I don't know. Either way, it's good. So now we just got to kill this giant son of a bitch. So if you could die at like any point, sir, I'd really appreciate that. I don't think he takes much physical damage. So maybe we want to give him like what would he be weak to? That's a great question. Oh, fuck it. Let's just keep beating him up, man. Which might be a good idea to just smack Squall around and get, like, his Rins no Pukins. Let's try that. Doesn't do much damage to himself, does he? What does Squall do? Zell, rather. Much better. Much better. Boop. Okay. Should be low enough. Holy crap. You can't just do that now. No! You dick. I'd like to point out, Zell has 1337 HP. That's pretty late. No! Oh my God, no! You stop taking out my Squall. I'm trying to bloody use him, you dick. You dick. Oh my God, all right, do it right now. Okay, we're fine. We're absolutely fine. Yeah, get up, Dave. You show that to who's boss. All right, slow it down, champ. I mean, it was perfect, but it wasn't very powerful, was it? Let's speed that part up. That part's slow as hell. You, I mean, I try GF, I guess. Again, this is super speed. This is blasting zone at super speed. It is so freaking slow. Oh my God, that was pants. That was just awful. Just awful. Oh God, yeah, I'm not gonna be able to boost this thing at super speed. It's been a while since we saw Ifrit, so I'll leave the summon animation in. It's not that long, is it really? It's basically over now, anyway. 105 boost, well, that's something. What does it do? Decent damage. These things are going to be tanky, though. Don't get me wrong. Try Tomber, try Shiva on you. Because, I mean, we can. Fantastic. Alright, if I remember to, I'll probably count out the rest of these animations. Well, maybe I'll stay here in silence, because I'll forget. Boop! Yeah. That'll teach him. Hey, I think he's dead. Suck it, you giant iron son of a bastard blue bitch. Alright, first things first, let's heal people, because we came a little close to dying there. Alright, brothers learned something. So I guess that would be a second thing, because we're going to sort this out, because otherwise I'll forget. You suck. You can learn cover, I guess. I don't know. All right. Higher potions for all. Whee! There we go. Now let's put on our super speed again and get the crap out of here! Woo! I might... Yeah, it's probably a good idea that I stuck up there, but it's not going to happen, I guess. What is Tombury learning? Have we not learned the shop thing yet? No. And we still need to learn Haggle. And I think there might be something else after that. I don't know. Gotta learn some stuff. I may have to do some grinding off-screen to get some of these abilities. Again, we need the one on Alexander, I think, if nothing else. So does anyone remember how to get to the palace? Because frankly, Jason doesn't. I think it's just at the north end, so we'll just keep going around, we should get there. Again, I'm going to leave on the encounter half, just because there are some useful things around here. This, I am going to use though, because screw doing that again. What the? Oh, you run up the blue bit. Well, alright then. So let's slow it down for a second here, and see... Junction Magic. Now, the one I'm most interested to check out is Reflect. See, look at the RHP there. 2,600. 3,600. An extra 1,000 HP because Reflect is so much better than Life for that. I think it might even be good for strength. Okay, well, it's still good for strength, but not as good as Zomball, apparently. Exactly the same as Slow for Magic. Really good for Spirit. I think I did mention that it would probably be good for Spirit. Not sure about speed evasion, etc. So let's just do that right now. Boop. And then... Junction Magic to you. Alright, so let's have a quick look-see. See if any of these are going to be better ideas. No, I still think it's better off used there. Though, now Life might be better somewhere else. You see, this is why I just tend to do auto. You know? Where's me Reflect? There you go. We only have 44 Ultima, which I guess is not horrible out of 100, but it's still, like, by far the best thing for our strength. That's how damn good it is. It's even better than 100. 44 Ultima is still significantly better for your HP than Reflect is. That's what I mean. It's the best spell in the game. Like, just hands down. I'm pretty sure it's, like, the best for every single junction. But you can obviously only put it in one place, because you can't have two stacks. Okay, so his life is on vitality. Just really quickly check to see if life is better for, like, strength in particular. It's better for... yeah, you know what? Auto to attack. Auto to attack. And auto... No. Auto to attack. That's the way to do it. Alright, save again, because I don't remember if we even did last time. Plus, we just messed around with a bunch of shit. Okay. And let's keep going. I feel so slow now without the speed up on my gear. What's up with this thing? This thing looks useless. It's broken. Sure is. Just need to do the seat exams. Just need to do them. There's another one of these things over here. And we have arrived, boys. We have arrived at the palace. At least I think so. Okay. What is this crouching? Yes, I want to go to the palace. It's a bit forever trying to get here. Okay, good. It's not as slow as the last one. But again, that's so cool. Again, I really want to do the rest of the seed exam things. I don't remember how many we did. I think only up to around 20. Maybe not even that high. We still have quite a few left. And again, there are 30. It's really not even that necessary at this point in the game, but... we should have just died a long time ago. But again, you can only do it up to level 30, and you have to be level 30, and blah, blah, blah. So we literally just hit that. So we couldn't even have done any, like all of them up until today anyway. You have permission, please, this way. Well, I mean, I would hope so. I'm the main character. Do we go over there on the right, or do we speak to this fella? Prison is waiting. Well, yes, but where? Can I... No, can't go in there. What are you? Okay, you click on the couch. Naturally. Are you the president now? You never know. He might be. They might be running out of people. Oh, he just walked out. What a dick. What the... Dr. Odin, he's still an important figure in Estar. I mean, yeah... Do I go in here now? No? Do I follow him? What am I doing? How's that what you want from me? Present is what? What? Do I click on this again? No. Struggling outside. Okay, I'm hoping it's over here that we have to go, because I'm a little confused. If not, it must be here, right? Well, it's looking good so far. Oh, thank God. Ward? Kiros? And that's probably... I'm legit about to sneeze. I hope you know this. Well, you didn't, but you do now. Unless you're psychic. I mean, you could be. That's awesome. I mean, if you are, like, give me the lottery numbers or something. I'd really appreciate that. New ones, that is. And what is up with this country? Oh, sure. Hey there! Nice shirt, you Hawaiian son of a bitch. It's not really Hawaiian, is it? Been wanting to meet you guys. You guys are the ones who were inside my head, right? Alone told me. It was like there were some kind of waves running through my head. They gave us so much power during battle. We thought there were some kind of fairies flying over us. So I'm Laguna, President Laguna Lowry of Estar. That's right, he's the president, I remember now. Pleased to meet you. If we weren't in a state of emergency, I'd talk to you some more. But, well, whatever. Let's talk. What do you want to know? You'll never get going if President Laguna keeps talking. So why don't you guys throw out some questions, and he'll try to answer them. Oh, okay. Man, you look way too serious. Whatever. Explain the mission to defeat old Demetrio was alone to me about Rin. Where are you doing it? Let's start from the basics. What are you doing here? You know what I've been doing all my life, right? You were a silly Albanian soldier. I didn't like your attitude at all. But I understand the bond between the three of you. Then you changed after you went to Windhill. Then Alone was abducted by Estar and you went on a journey. A journey to get Alone back. You wrote articles and appeared in movies to get by. You were trying to find a way into Estar. You somehow got into Estar and rescued Alone. I got a lot of help along the way. What I don't understand is, why are you the president? Wanna know? It's a long story. Oh, God. Yes, I do wanna know, though. You wanna hear it? Really? Okay, I'll tell you. I only set out to be... good start. I only set out to rescue Alone, but of course, that wasn't the end of the story. It's a country ruled by Sorceress Adele with the ingenious yet inhumane Odin. Odin? Fuck it, I don't know what his name is. Both of them were interested in Alone. We couldn't just pack up and leave. Adele will be angry. My research will be corrupt. A kaput, rather. That's also not how you spell corrupt with a K. Odin only thought about his research. I'm gonna call him Odin, and we're gonna stick with that, alright? I've decided. Odin sounds stupid. But while researching under Adele's orders, he was still making many inventions. It was a device to seal magic. Sealing facility in brackets. Maybe Adele can be defeated. I owed a big favor to the Adele resistance who helped me rescue Alone. I spoke with my comrades. Two issues came up. First, stopping the crystal pillar from calling monsters from the moon and destroying everything like what happened in Sentra. Second, freeing Estar from Adele's hands. We planned and planned based on my brilliant ideas, of course. He's not kidding, is he? This is a long bloody story. Don't forget, this is how he became president. He's setting all of this up. We're back. Back in the Lunatic Pandora Research Facility. There is only one goal. Following Odin's instructions, We operated the panel and moved the crystal pillar. We set the course and the stop point in the ocean and... goodbye. Whoa! That was easy, but we were found out. So we gathered for a final battle to Luridel. I apologize, my reading skills are a bit shit right now. I'm doing my best. I'm very tired. Again, look at the size of Adele, man, and the fact that she got a man's chest. It's a little strange. Adele appeared as we expected. Also, you know, horns. What is going on? We hunted down the culprits who moved the crystal pillar. Where? Inside there. Alone's been taken hostage. I knew she'd be going right away if I mentioned Alone. Ah, so this is how they trapped her. I guess his reward was becoming present. You thought I would fall for that trick? Okay. Perfect shot there. That is a fucking man's torso, okay? This is a lady. A very humongous lady with a man's torso. Really strange. Adele realized that Alone was a hologram, but it was too late. Yeah, of course. My plans are always... perfect! Kira's Ward now! Yeah! I called an Adele! Would you like to name your Adele? Ha ha ha, piece of cake. Adele was careless. She may be a sorceress, but after all, she was human. I mean... she don't look very human. We succeeded, but we couldn't keep such a dangerous sorceress around as a trophy. We had to do something. So, we decided to send her far, far away. Someplace very far, into outer space. Apparently on the Ragnarok. That's three Ragnaroks. Interesting. So I guess the one that we found was one of the ships that were escorting Adele's ship? Well, the ship that Adele was on, it's not really her ship. And that about wraps that part up. But the real work began after that. A fierce debate ensued about who should govern this country after Adele was gone. I wasn't paying close attention while they made me up to be this hero of the revolution and ended up being president. Odin made a lot of noise about wanting to do research on Alone. It was a mistake to send Alone back to, Alone back to Rain. Rain died, and Ellie was sent to the orphanage. If I had only gone to Windhill with Ellie, I would have been able to see Rain one last time. Rain was dead. Alone, missing. My job kept me busy. I was left here thinking about this and that, and before I knew it, all this time had passed. Well, that's about it. Oh, I can click on you again. So, let me out of this room! Where's Alone? We're gonna ask all this shit, just so you know. And then, think of the bright side, when we're done with this dialogue here in Estar, I'm pretty sure it's at the point where they're gonna be like, go finish the game. Then we do all the side crap, killing bosses and whatnot. What the heck has he done with his life? Don't you wonder? When Alone was about two, there was a massive hunt for girls in Estar. As the soldiers came to Windhill and Ellie's parents resisted, they were killed on the spot. The massive hunt was to find the successor for Estar's ruler, Sorceress Adele. Alone was raised by Rain, who lived next door, and I came to know her. Then there was another massive hunt for a successor in Estar again. Ellie was taken away even though I was there. It's the most painful episode of my life. So I rescued her and sent her off to Windhill. Shortly after that, Rain died. And Alone was sent straight to an orphanage. Why didn't you go back to Windhill with her? I wanted to! But I had my reasons. I found out about this afterwards, but the reason why Alone had to leave the orphanage was because of her special power. Dr. Odin went to do research on Alone's special power. He looked for her everywhere. The owners of the orphanage were Sid Kramer and his wife Edia. You know them better than I do. The Kramers took Ellie out of the orphanage to protect her. They prepared a big ship to accommodate her. Gracious of them, huh? After a while, the ship turned into another orphanage, and Ellie looked after all the kids. She said her life on the ship was a happy one, but who knows? I don't know how she could have been happy on a ship. She was on the ship for over 10 years. The ship was attacked by Galbadia recently. Estar's ship rescued them, and she finally met up with me. It was pure luck that we found her. I was out in space all that time, or at the time, I alone followed me out to space. Little Ellie was all grown up. Then she told me everything. Did she get back safely from space? Our escape pod rescue team was a little late. Ellen was taken into custody by Galbadia. She's inside Lunatic Pandora. We're gonna rescue her. Help us out, okay? Woo! So, I have to save her before I do the end? My god. My god. Tell me about Rain, and then we have one more question. Rain's story some other time, maybe. No, I can't. It's too much for me to remember. Alright then. Explain the mission, bitch! Ah, straight to the heart of the matter. Yes, exactly. Just like a workaholic seed. Is it my turn? Yeah, make it short and easy to understand. I will talk however I want. Eh. Sorceress Edia told me everything. Sorceress Artemisia comes from the future to possess the sorceress of the present day. Meaning she lives her body in the future and sends only her consciousness here. Does that sound familiar to you? It's like when a lone sinner or consciousness is... My god, that's a huge word. Look at the size of that fucking thing! That's so many letters. It's like when a lone sinner or consciousness is back to the past. It's also kind of satisfying to say. Consciousnesses. Try doing it at home right now. Consciousnesses. Do it with me together. Consciousnesses. Beautiful. You're a smart one. My first guess was that someone in the future with an ability like Alone was sending the sorceress back here to our time. But no, that is not the answer. So how does this sorceress come back to this time? You want to hear how? Fucking hell yes. Lay it on me, Doc. Yeah. I kept this a secret. I'm gonna read it in normal English, so hopefully we can understand. I kept this a secret to surprise you. It is because of me, Odine. Or whatever my fucking name is. I researched Alone's power long ago. I made out a pattern from the electric current running through Alone's brain. Once the pattern was determined, it was easy to mechanize. It may only be a toy right now, but in the time of Artemisia, it is an impressive working machine. Which means there is a machine which imitates Alone's power. It is I who made the first model of that machine. I named the machine Junction Machine Alone. That's a stupid name. This is very Terminator, I'd like to point out. It is a wonderful thing to know that my invention is used in the future. Junction Machine Alone. That's about it. So Sorceress Own Media came to know about Alone from that machine. And Ellie became Artemisia's targets. You can't blame Odine, it's useless. I keep switching between Odine and Odine, it's driving me mad. My brain can't even remember which one I'm going with. You want to go outside? You want to fisticuffs? Okay, we continue the story. Let's see. There is only one way to defeat Artemisia. You must kill her in the future. There is nothing we can do unless we go to the future. There is no way to jump to the future under normal circumstances. But there is still a way. It is because Sorceress Artemisia plans to compress time. Compressing time with magic. What good will it do for the sorceress to compress time? There may be many reasons, but it doesn't matter. Let's just figure out what Artemisia is up to. Alright, I'm absolutely gonna cut that out. I read most of this and then did the grossest burp. In order for Artemisia to exist in this time, she must take over the body of a sorceress from the future. Or the president, rather. Son of a bitch. But the machine must have a limit. Artemisia probably needs to go back further in time to achieve time compression. Only Alone can take her back. Oh my god. Only Alone can take her back further into the past. That is why she is desperately seeking her. Okay. So let me summarize this in a way that I can understand. Okay. Because this is not explained terribly well. At least I don't think so. Artemisia, from future. Alone has a time travel brain. Okay. Artemisia, in order to fuck up the present day, which to her is the past, needs to take over the body of a sorceress. No one else will do. Alone is the key to this all. And as is Adele. Because Adele is, you know, an evil, powerful sorceress. We must take advantage of Alone's power. There are two sorceresses in our time, Sorceress Rinoa and Sorceress Adele. Of the two, Adele has not awakened yet. Once regeneration is completed, neither Laguna nor I will be safe. Sorceress Adele is probably in the process of awakening inside Lunatic Pandora. Artemisia will want to possess Adele if Adele wakes up. That will be a horrible event. Adele is a horrible sorceress. If Adele's consciousness wins over Artemisia, Adele will first destroy this era. So we must use Sorceress Rinoa to inherit Artemisia's powers. That's all for the mission briefing.
I think I've gone cross-eyed. I've lost me mojo.
First, go to Lunatic Pandora. Alone's probably being held captive inside, so go rescue her first. Then kill Sorceress Adele before she awakens, or before the awakening process is completed. Now we're left with Rinoa as the only sorceress of this era. Then wait for Artemisia to possess Rinoa. Then BAM! Kill Rinoa. When Artemisia arrives, it's Alone's turn. Alone will send Rinoa back to the past with Artemisia.
I'm so fucking confused.
Alone will have to send Rinoa and Artemisia inside another sorceress she knows in the past. What? Edie or Adele? That's up to Alone. Once Artemisia is in the past, she'll use the time compression magic. We will see some influence here. I don't know what kind of influences, but Alone feels it. She'll cut Rinoa and Artemisia off from the past. Rinoa will come back to this world. Artemisia also goes back to her own world. I'm so confused. I mean, I get what they're saying, but man, this is like a Kingdom Hearts level of batshit insane. What will be left is the time compression world. Past, present, and future will all get mixed together. You'll keep moving through the time compression toward the future. Once you're out of the time compression, that will be Artemisia's world. Alrighty then. It's all up to you after that. Okay. Hey, bud. You're huge and you can't talk. What? Let me out of this room. What funny looking clothes. You want to try it on? Actually, yes, I do. Oh, I can't. I guess we have to say we want to get let out of this room. So you were briefed about the mission. I don't really understand it either. Will you do it? Yes. Yes, I will.
All right.
Let's go. We'll get aboard Ragnarok. Let's do the final briefing in there. Oh boy, more briefing. I always wanted to ride that thing. Plus, the name sounds so cool. I mean, you're not wrong. It's a pretty badass name. Again, I think it's like a mythological thing of some description. Like a sword or something. I don't know. Alright. Everyone. From here, we go straight to our final target, Artemisia. Let's go over the plan again. First, enter Lunatic Pandora and rescue Alone. Next, you fight Sorceress Adele. It'll be a surprise attack. Show no mercy. Now, here comes the tricky part. Adele will need to pass on her powers before being defeated. Rinoa, will you be willing to accept them? Yes. Good. Next, we wait for Sorceress Artemisia to possess Rinoa. This will be hard on you, Rinoa, but will you do it? Yes. That's the spirit, champ. Then Alone sends Rinoa and Artemisia to the past. I'm with you so far. Alone brings back Rinoa. I got it, yes. Then head to the future through compressed time. Artemisia lives far in the future where none of us can technically exist. There's only one way to make yourself exist in a world like that. As friends, don't forget one another. As friends, believe in one another. Believe in your friend's existence, and they'll also believe in yours. All you have to do is believe. To be friends, to like one another, and to love one another. You can't do these things alone. You need somebody.
Everybody.
Yeah, I'm not gonna do it. Right, guys, what place reminds you of your friends? Imagine being in that place with all your friends. Once time compression begins, think of that place and try to get there. That's all. That place will welcome you. You'll be able to get there no matter what period you're in. You need love and friendship for this mission, and the courage to believe it. How lame. It's all about love, friendship, and courage. I'm counting on you guys. No, it's not. It's about kicking ass. Love and friendship and all that sounds corny, but everyone seems to be up for it. You think it'll succeed? We'll try. See, he said all that shit, and then... Oh, his leg's messed up again because he's nervous. He said all that crap about love and friendship, and then he said, do you think it's going to succeed? So really, he just made all that up. And at least school also thinks it's corny. That makes me like school a little bit more. Let's park up here for a second. Let us save really quick. And then even though this is going to be a monstrously long fucking episode, I don't care. We're going to beat Laguna because he's got a card, and then we're going to do the rest of these goddamn state exams, and then that's it. That's it for this episode. Then we're ready to, I gotta go find him now. How does one leave? You go down, you muppet! But anyway, after that, then we're ready to do all the science stuff, beginning next episode, and, yeah. It's gonna be a lot of fun, man. A lot of fun. He's not in here, is he? You know he is? Okay. You know some rules we don't use around here? Let's play a game with Luna's rules than us. Let's not do that, because screw Luna's rules, man! No? No, no, no. I don't remember if the Ragnarok has its own rules. I mean, I guess so? Or it might depend, like, where you've parked the Ragnarok? Or something? No, buddy, stop asking about this. No, stop asking. Stop asking! Just stop asking. Okay, how many times? Alright. Elemental and Rule 1. So we can't see his cards, but besides that, it's not bad at all. So again, he does have a red card. I think he has... I don't want to spoil it for you. It's a little strange. Oh, there you go. It's a little strange what card he has. The school card. He ain't school, man. Oh, I don't get it. All right, see that? We'll probably get taken by his next card, but it's not a big deal. And then we can do... Eh, this seems safe enough. We could use Edir as well. We could possibly even get away with Sifa. No, okay, so he's got some boss cards going on. All right, I'm going to do this. I think this will be perfectly safe. I want to keep the Rinoa card for the end. Oh, you penis muncher. No. Alright, let's do that and hope that he can't take it back. It would really suck if he does. No, we drew! Oh, come on, man. Alright, we should have been more aggressive. God damn. That was impressive. Considering he... Well, he didn't have a horrible cards. He just won that great. Have the card again. Lovely. Alright, this time. Ah, we're gonna go with the same thing. It's the only thing we can really do and be reasonably safe. Perfect. Absolutely perfect. You've pretty much cooked your own goose, my friend. I'm gonna double down on this one. It's easy to take the Sifa card from there, which he didn't do. Even better. Then I'll take you as well, and then he's in such a deficit now, like, what can he really do? And then we do this, and at best he's gonna take, the Gizzard card back, but he's still gonna be down a point. There you go. Boop! Thank you very much. Right, so which seed exam thingy are we on? Let's have a look here. Tutorial test 24. Okay, so we're on 25. So we only got like 5 more to go. Wait, is that 6 more? It's 6 more. You can monk a laser cannon, from an enemy called Elastoid. I don't think so. That is an enemy. I don't think a laser cannon's a thing, though. I think a laser cannon is a move that maybe it uses? I'm gonna say no. Leviathan's skill Tsunami causes a forest fire. How high are you on a scale of 1 to Snoop Dogg? Like, who wrote that question? No. I use Amnesia Greens to make a GF forget an ability. You can make a GF forget an ability. Is it Amnesia Greens? I thought it was called something else. Isn't Amnesia Greens for a chocobo? I'm sure it's got a different name. But I'm going to say yes anyway. There's an ability to see save points and draw points you can't usually see. Yes, it's called Move Find. GF gains more XP if only one GF is junctioned to a party member. Probably. I don't actually know. I'm going to say no. It is good to return to Balam Garden once in a while to collect your seed salary. No, you don't need to do that. Of course, by this point in the test, you would know the answer to that, wouldn't you? You would have been paid by that point. The Magic Waterer and Water Gut are more powerful than the Magic Water. I'm 99% sure there is no such thing. There is water, there's no Waterer or Water Gut, as far as I remember. It's strange. Like, in some of the games like Final Fantasy VII, There's no water element, for example, in that one, but there's, like, Quake. But there's, like, in Final Fantasy VII, they weren't called, like, Ra and Aga. They were called, like, Quake 1, Quake 2, Quake 3. There's definitely Quake 1, 2, and 3 in 7. But in 8, I'm pretty sure it's just Quake, which is a little strange. So, anyway, no. Counter doesn't react to attacks which affect all party members. What? Oh, I know what you mean. True, I think? GF can learn an ability to succeed in every mug by using an item called Bandit's Hand. I mean, I really don't think so. That sounds very strange. You can draw magic that causes curse. No. 80. Alright, well, we did alright. So again, when we get the test wrong, I'm just gonna look up the friggin' answers. Because it just... You know, I'd rather not be here like an hour per bloody exam. So let's go to 25 on the list, and we're looking at yes, no, yes, 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 no, no, yes, no, and no. Beautiful. Okay, using Drain on the undead damages you. I don't actually know. I'm going to say no. The character ability initiative enables you to begin battle with a full ATB gauge even when you are back attacked. Probably? The command ability Dark Side inflicts darkness on a target when you make a physical attack. I don't think it actually does. I could be wrong. I think it just... I don't remember. I don't remember! No. Holy is the only holy elemental magic. Technically, yes. Alexander is also a holy GF. He's... So, between... There's one holy magic. It's holy. There's one holy GF. It's Alexander. That is it, as far as I'm aware. So I'm going to say yes. I mean, they might be kind of cheating here, and they might be including the GF. If so, fuck them. Even GFs that are not junction gain XP and AP. Nope. Shell reduces the effectiveness of recovery magic by half. Yes. With a high evade stat, you sometimes evade attacks even when under sleep. Probably. You can make GF forget an ability. Yes. Doom continues counting down in the field even after you run from battle. Nope. I don't think so. Attack magic is more effective if your strength rather than magic stat is higher. That would be very strange. It could be true, but I doubt it. Ah, we got 80 again. We kind of consistently get 80. There's always like one or two that trips me up. Alright, so we're looking at no... rather, yes, yes, no, yes, no, yes, no, yes, and then no, and then no. Beautiful. Alright, we're almost done, boys. Haste reduces drawer's success rate. I hope not, because that was haste when I was hasted. When I was drawing from that Iron Giant. When I was getting Reflect and Haste for that matter. I'm going to say no, but it might. Your seed salary relates to how many enemies you have defeated. No. How would you get to level 27 and not fucking know that? The double GF ability summons multiple GF simultaneously. There's no such thing as a double GF ability. Choose... Rearrange in the menu to rearrange items automatically. It's called sort, isn't it? Isn't rearrange like manual? I don't know, I'm gonna say no. Every monster has a weakness. Not true. Bio weakens the target's cell structure to make the body more vulnerable. No, it's fucking poison. It's harder to run when back attacked. Maybe? I'm gonna go with... no. Flare is a fire elemental magic. No, it's actually non-elemental. I'm 99% sure. You can find out how many monsters you have defeated. I think so in the log somewhere. Party members not participating in battle also receive a small amount of EXP. No. 80. Again. My god. Alright, so. 27 is... Holy crap, that's all I know. No. Yes. No. 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 No again. Yes. No. Yes. No. So close, man. 28 says, the higher speed stat fills the A to B gauge faster. Yeah. That's the entire point of it. You can remove Doom with a Sooner. I don't think you can remove Doom. Let's put it that way. I'm pretty sure it can't be removed. I might be wrong. Magic attack means attacking with... See, the thing is as well about questions like that... I'm pretty sure in some Final Fantasies, you can't remove Doom at all. And in some of them, you probably can. So it's hard to remember which Final Fantasy it applies to. Magic attack means attacking with any type of magic except for holy magic. See, I don't know about that one, because as I mentioned, in Final Fantasy IX, your white mage, which is traditionally a healer, does learn holy, as is the case in several Final Fantasies. So technically, holy is considered sort of a white magic, as opposed to black magic, kind of healer type of thing. But there isn't character classes in this game. But it could scale... Well, no, what would it scale with if it didn't... What would it scale with if it didn't scale with magic? Because there's no, like, cured stat that you can junction to, so I'm going to say that's force. No magic removes doom. See? There's like two... Look, this is in relation to what I said before. I think that's true. Pain inflicts poison, silence, and darkness on enemies. But sometimes not all three status changes will occur. Is there actually a spell called pain? I don't remember. Okay, no, I don't think it's a spell. I think the enemy Triface can use that. And it makes sense, right? Try three, it's three different things. I think it's a move that Triface has. But sometimes not all three status changes will occur. We'll say sure, yes. Staying at a hotel removes status changes and restores your HP. Yep. You can stop scores Renz Okuken by pressing B1. I'm pretty bloody sure you can't stop it. Why would you want to? Double or triple lets you use the same magic multiple times, correct? Petrify wears off after time passes. No. Using soft while petrifying won't stop the countdown. Probably correct, yes. 90. We got one wrong. Okay. Alright, let's have a look here. This is 28. We've got yes. No. No. Yes, yes, yes. No, yes. No. No. Alright. 29. Two more left. Phoenix Heart restores party members from KO. I don't even know what Phoenix Heart is, so I'm going to say no. It might be an item, though, because there's a lot that are very rare that you can only make from cards and refining things and blah, blah, blah. I'm just going to say no. A GF in KO is revived in the next battle, even if you don't revive it. We know that is now not true, because we left Diablos on Diablos. Diablos? It's Diablos. Diablos? We left Dave dead for quite a while. So no. Casting double one, double turns the status into triple. I don't think so, but you never know. That could be a kind of cool thing. Magic up raises the magic step by one. Yeah, sure. The ability rare item changes the probability of enemies dropping rare items. I think there is an ability like that. I don't remember if that's what it's called. I would just say yes. The Galbanian soldier Bix, who was on the communications tower, is a colonel. Oh, shit. Hang on, let me think. Lieutenant Bix, I think. A Colonel Wedge? Yeah, I think that's the way it works. Because isn't Wedge the red one and the red one's a higher ranker? Higher ranker. Higher rank. So I think he's Lieutenant Biggs. He got demoted though, didn't he? Or both of them, or one of them got demoted? I don't remember. We'll say no. You need at least three magic in stock to use triple. I don't think that's actually true. I might be wrong. I'm going to say no on that one. If two party members are under a zombie and you become inflicted by confused, game is over. No? Menior chooses targets randomly from the enemy group. I believe so, yes. Meltdown is a magic attack that melts enemies. No? Hey, we actually fucking hell, I'm the greatest. I got an achievement and everything. I got an achievement. Your C rank will go up to A. I got A? Can I even take another test? Okay, I can, but my C rank won't go up. Let's do it. It's the last one anyway. Yes. Oh, son of a bitch. Really? Yes. Your test level is now 29. We take level 30. Yes. Bloody hell. I was about to look at the cheat sheet thing and then I realized, no, you actually got it right for once, Jason. It is good to use float when fighting Thrustivus, who uses earthquakes. I don't think so. I think he's like an airy dude, because it's like a big bird, and birds usually use air magic. So, I guess I know. There is no point using life or full life on party members who haven't been KO'd. That is absolutely correct, yes. If you receive 800 HP damage while summoning a GF with 500 HP, the difference of 300 HP are received by the summoner. Not true. Toruma sometimes drops an item called Toruma's Beard. I don't think so. They're the weird cat-like things with the long antenna, kind of tentacly ear beard things. I'm just guessing now. Casting aura under curse will bring your status back to normal. I'm not sure. See, aura is a thing, but I never use it. So I don't, it's one of those magic spells I'm very unfamiliar with, so I'm gonna say no. There is a monster called Grabia on the Galbadia continent. Nope. I know every fucking enemy name in this game. That's one thing I do know. Silence is not removed even after battle. Correct. Reflect always returns magic to the one who cast it. Not true. I think it's random. So for example, say the enemy's reflected. Like, so it's one boss. And we cast it with Score. We cast, like, fire, and it reflects back. I'm pretty sure it's random if it will reflect back on, like, Score or one of the other party members. Status can change while under Petrify. I don't know exactly what that means. See, when someone's petrified, they're stone. They're dead, essentially. I think they are immune to other status changes because they are literally considered to be dead and to use assault on them. Again, it depends on the Final Fantasy game. In some games, I think that is true. In some games, I don't think it is. So I'm just going to say no. The only way for GF to learn abilities is to gain AP. I'm pretty sure? It depends, because you can use items to teach them abilities, but I think you still have to gain the AP for them. 90. Okay, so I'm going to get one wrong. So we're not doing awfully. What, we've got like a bunch of 80s, a perfect, and a 90? That's not bad, man. Let's take the written test. Yes, yes, yes. Alright, so, last test. No, yes, no, 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 yes, and then the rest are no. Status change. Alright! So that's it. We got the school card. We beat every single goddamn test, finally. We finished all of the main story, besides basically going to the end of the game now. So what we have left is all of the optional stuff, so we've got... Let's have a look here. Let's have a look. We have 4 GFs to pick up. This one, I know what this is. There's also Bahamut. I'll spoil that one for you. I know what that one is. Okay, I know what all 4 of them are. We're probably not going to get all 4 in one episode. It depends how long the episode goes. But that will be what we will start working on next time. I might do some grinding off screen to learn some abilities. For example, if I park up here. For example, like the med data ability on Alexander so that we can get the other one. To then, you know, get Remedy Pluses to make Doom Train or blah blah blah. Use the Solomon's Ring. You get the point. Anyway, that's going to do it for today's episode. It's been a long one. Thank you for joining me. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, I would appreciate it. Like it. I will see you next time for more Final Fantasy VIII. The road to finishing the game. Thank you for watching, and good night, everybody. Goodbye.